Welcome, Pirate fans. We're here at the historic RFK Stadium to watch our very own Hampton University Pirates beat the Howard University Bison in the AT&T Nations Football Classic. This is the Battle of the Real HU. Last season, our very own Hampton University Pirates beat the Howard Bison 37-19, making the record of the series 5-2. Earlier this week, during a press conference with Coach Manor, he stated that in order to win today's game, they will have to take advantage of opportunities, not turning away the ball or getting penalties during the game. They will have to be consistent in order to win today's game as well. The key players for today's game are Rashawn Proctor and TJ Mixon, as well as Yaki Johnson, who had a game high last week, rushing 115 yards with 12 carries. This is a game that you guys don't want to miss. My name is Rachel Prevett. Go Pirates!
Run it back, TJ!
Williamson, handoff to Ed Carter Jr., untouched. It's a touchdown for Hampton, and the Pirates have taken the lead. It's 6-0.
Touchdown, Pirates.
Thank you.
get it, Brock. Get out, get out, get out, get out, get out.
Welcome back, Pirate fans. We're here at the AT&T's Nations Football Classic at the RFK Historic Stadium. The current score is 7-0. The Pirates are currently up. This has been a very interesting game. First half of the game has been a very defensive game. The Pirates have been struggling offensively to move the ball, as well as the Howard University Bisons as well. Number 22, Yaki Johnson, is doing a very good job rushing the ball. He's been gaining a lot of yardage, and we had a lot of contributing plays in this first half of the game. The score is 7-0. Eric Carter, number 21, scored the first touchdown, but he was assisted by number 86, Jack Willenberg. The Pirates are doing a pretty good job in the first half of the game, but in order to keep up the momentum, we're gonna have to do a lot better in the second half. This is Rachel Prevett from the Hampton University Pirates.
And the punt was two. That's caught out of the air. This is going to be a touchdown for Hampton on special teams. Number 28, Bruce Perry, scores for the Pirates. Blockers for him. They pull a guard and Cox spins off the defensive end and into the end zone. It's a touchdown for Hampton. Brandon Cox, a transfer from Utah. Lebowski at his own 10. Comes forward to the 13 and kicks it away. Bell's going to return this one. Catches it at the 30. Makes a man miss at the 35. Back into the middle of the field. He's still on his feet. Getting through traffic. He's going to the Hampton sideline. Turns the corner. 40. He's at the 30. And then he gets stood up right there. Williamson is under center. Williamson will drop back. Williamson will throw. Johnson in the flat. Johnson to the 20. Johnson cutting back across field to the 15. Johnson to the 10. Johnson to the 5. Johnson to the pylon. It's a touchdown for Hampton. Key Johnson scores, and it's 30-0 Pirates. They are spotting the football at the 41-yard line. Jay, this is a 51-yard field goal attempt. Snap, spot, kick. It's up in the air. It's high enough. Is it long enough? It is! It's gone!
Welcome back, Pirate fans. We're here with the head coach of the Hampton University football team, Coach Maynard. First off, congratulations on your win in the first conference game of the season.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Going into halftime, what did you tell your team in order to pick up the momentum going into the second half of the game?
Well, we kind of just shot ourselves in the foot a little bit. Made some mistakes, had some penalties that killed some drives, and we couldn't never get in a rhythm. I couldn't get in a rhythm as a play caller because we kept getting penalties and killing ourselves. So we just said we got to calm down, relax. We know the plays are there. We got to go out and cut out the penalties and just play Pirate football, and that's what we did the second half.
And also, with this being the first game of the conference, what do you plan on taking from this game as you further into the season?
Oh, well, we got to go back and watch the tape. We made some mistakes, and we can continue to get better. So we got to watch the tape and continue to get better. We got a week off, and then we play North Carolina A&T, and they have a week off. So it's even Steven. Both of us are going to have a week off, and we got to get ready to play the best team in the league.
We're here with key player number 22, Yaki Johnson. Going into the game today, what were your thoughts playing your rival school?
My thoughts was just do my job. Everybody had to do their job. I was just worrying about myself, and that's pretty much it. You know, long as I did my job, I knew that was helping the team out.
And also, what key play do you felt contributed to your win today?
Actually, when I scored the 82, the screen actually, you know, I saw it was an open and a cross field, and I just saw green and I scored. I felt like the 82 kind of helped us.